Hey folks, it's Frithgar here, how you doing? Welcome back to old times. Our international tractor is working away up there, which reminds me, our weekly question, which tractor do you want me to buy? Would you like me to buy the Ford TW30, which we've been trying out up the top, or do you want me to buy this international, that one there, with the front linkage, the international 1255. This is 125 horsepower. And the Ford is 193 horsepower. So it's your vote, it's your game. Head down to the comment section down below, let me know which one you want. Now, this one is on hire, and I remembered to renew the hire of the tractor and the plough, but I forgot to renew the hire of the front weight that was on it. And you will have to sort of forgive the going through the hedge here, but I've been trying to do lots of ploughing, so... Yeah, he's also bouncing around a huge amount because he's not got the front weight on anymore. So he does seem to be bouncing a lot more than he was. But he's nearly finished. He's done this field, and he's done this field over here. The Kirovets, we missed a little bit there. The cultivator can pick up some bits, just so long as most of it is actually finished beforehand. Where did I put the Kirovets? The Kirovets is here somewhere. We haven't yet got to doing anything here. I do need to try and find a... suitable wood chipper, because we were talking about what wood it could take over here. That one there, which one, what wood this could take, it can only take wood chips or sawn lumber. So I need to find something to chip up some wood, and I'm not sure which one I'm going to use. Okay, that is something that I need to do. I got to find a suitable wood chipper, and I've no idea which, but we'll get to that. Now, what was the next thing I wanted to do? I'm actually heading over this way because we've got the twin wheels for the Kirovets. I've been doing some ploughing with it. I've got the twin wheels over here, but I need to actually transport them over to it. So I will do that, and then we can head back up and we can have a look at the mowing that we were doing, because we've mowed all of that field down. Right, here it is. I don't need to leap ahead. I'm going to be really energetic today, and I'm going to jump the hedge. There we go. Jump the wall, I should say. Right. So we got the Volvo here. The sheep, the wool, is actually ready to collect. And the pallet forks, they're over there as well with the sheep. So let's just pick that one up. We have now bought this one. This is ours. We no longer need to rent it. We no longer need to worry about the rental prices or anything like that. So let's rush this over to the sheep, and we can get that pallet of wool. We can sell that one, which would probably be a good idea because we are fast eating through our money. And then once we've sold that one, we can come back and we can get those twin wheels and drag them over the Kirovets. He's just got himself stuck on the tree. Let me sort that out, and then I will go and do the pallet of wool. Now, the International has finished that little field. Don't need to worry about that one anymore. And I never left the... pallet forks over here, did I? I left the pallet forks back at the yard. They are in one of the sheds, now that I come to think of it. The Kirovets is in, not this field, he's in the next one up. Field one, sort of up at the back there. So we've got that one to finish off, and then we've got field three to do. And he's been using the four furrow plough, which is doing a grand job. The International has finished. I will return the plough, but I think I'll keep the International and we'll try a slightly larger cultivator, because we can use a small cultivator on one of these tractors here, but I would like to use a slightly bigger cultivator. It would be nice if we could do that. There's our pallet fork, so let's just grab that one a second. There we go. And I do normally use the manual attachments mod, but you don't. The manual attachments doesn't manually attach on the pallet forks. So, yeah, that one just auto... That's just got a quick hitch on it. I know that quick hitches weren't really used back in those days, but we'll just have to imagine that we're a rather enterprising farmer, and we have developed our own quick hitch system, so we don't have to get out of the cab. Now, we'll just nip over here. We'll get this next pallet of wool. This is the second pallet of wool that we've had from these sheep. We will at some point get some more sheep. I would like to increase the size of our flock. I feel that 250 sheep would be about right for this farm. 250 sheep and 120 cows. We've got 60 cows at the moment, which I think means that we'll have... I'm trying to remember how much you have for... Right. For some reason, my joystick is not working today. Oh, no, of course it doesn't. Ignore that. because I used the mouse the first time and I was wondering why the joystick didn't. The joystick doesn't work on the BM Volvo. For some reason, it's a different set of commands or something. I'm not quite sure. I'm guessing it's because it's a back-to-front tractor, and so it's not actually recognised by the game as a front loader, which is a little bit... It's sort of a bizarre way that it does it. But we're going to run this over to the spinnery, and then as soon as we've tipped this at the spinnery, we're going to rush back again, and we're going to get those twin wheels so that we can give them... Oops. Give them to the Kirovets, because I'd like to see him with the twin wheels doing some work. There we go. I'll let you see this one again. And there, because I never actually brought you up here, there's another €2,394. Here is where we sell. I put the honey bar up here. I thought this was a good spot for it. It was nice and flat. One of the most level spots that I could find in the map. So here is where we will bring our pallets of cereals and met, I think it's called. I believe it's mead that they're making. It's honey and water. We will bring them up here, and this is where we will sell them when we finally have something. But we've got to get wood chips before we can do that. So now I'm going to rush back down to the shop, and I'm going to pick up the Kirovets twin wheels, or at least I hope I can. Sometimes you can't move those crates of wheels around for some reason. So hopefully we can pick them up with this one. Now we find out if we can actually pick these up with pallet forks. I'm not sure if you can or not. Some of them you can, and some of them you can't. I think we'll be all right with this one. Whether we've got to try and get the pallet forks through those little loops there, or if it will just go underneath. Well, it goes in. Excellent! Look at that! We can pick them up. Has it come through them properly? I can't actually see underneath to see if it's done it properly. It's glitching. But that's okay, we've picked them up, so we can run these up to the Kirovets now, and then he can carry on with his ploughing, and he can do it in style. Right, here we go, he's been working away on here, and he does have a little bit of an issue down the other end. If I sort of do the headlands enough that they don't drive into the ditches and out on the end, it takes a very, very long time, and it kind of detracts from the enjoyment of the game. If I've got to do that myself every single time. I have considered using the auto tractor, something like that, and I may yet consider using it, but so far I've avoided doing that purely because... Right, can I assemble them yet? I've got to get a bit closer to assemble the... Let's just lift the plow up. Back up a little bit. Let me come round. Yeah, so I may or I may not use something like auto tractor. I'm not fully decided yet. What is he doing? He's jumping down a little bit. Because he's in the field and we've got this sort of the terrain dirt thing going on. I like the way that it bumps around and the tractor goes into the ground slightly, but at the same time I am considering putting it back to the one I had previously, which didn't seem to be quite so drastic. Right. Maybe I've got to unhitch the plough. So let me just try that a minute. Let's drop that down. Right, let me mess around here a minute and see if I can get this loaded on, because I got other stuff that I want to do. Right, I think you've just got to have them on the ground to do it. I haven't been able to get the trigger to come up when they weren't on the ground. So there we have twin wheels assembled. And climb off there. Right. Let me just move this frame back out of the way and then he can start ploughing again. Okay, the frame's right in the way of him. This is bad. He's very jumpy today. I wonder if I can just go down right underneath it. No, look at that. It's weird the way it's doing that. Okay, so I've got to line it up absolutely perfectly and get it through those two little holes. But because it's slightly in the ground anyway, I may not even be able to do that. Don't fail me now. Got it. That is not the easiest machine to get right. Okay, so we got the frame up. Let's just go and move this one over. Actually, I'll just leave that one there a second. We're going to start the Kirovets ploughing again. I want to see him with his twin wheels, because I've not actually tried this while he's been ploughing. So we'll put that down. We'll let him go. Beautiful. He's such a beast, this thing. He really is. And that's our tractor, actually. Yeah, there's no rent time or anything like that on it. This is our tractor. Now, this is the bit. I've done some along this headland, but like I said, you can spend months, hours and hours and hours, if not months, trying to get this right. So he is actually backing out through the ditch a little bit, and that is unrealistic. I apologize for that. We're not going to be looking at that very often. I will set the ploughing going, and then we won't see it. So it's sort of a little crime that is hidden out of sight that we won't actually know about very often. I think we can live with that. I'm hoping we can. So anyway, I've got grass to do. So that one, he's going to carry on and do this field, and he's got one more to do after this one. The four furrow plough is doing a fantastic job. It is brilliant. So let me go and shift this out of the way, and then we can get on with the grass. Okay, I'm back up here. I have finished this field, and I will say now that I have slightly altered this mod because it was limiting the tractor quite a bit. So I've altered it to go the same speed as other machines. So let's just put it like that. So he does go a little bit faster now, which is something that I kind of needed. And we are assuming that this one is not the actual John Deere that we got here in front of us. It was a different one, which was the Agromech something. I can't remember the name of it now, which is frustrating me. But we have mowed this field. It is all done. I was going to row it up a bit, but what I think I'll do first is the mower is going to be mostly used up this end. So we will go and put this mower up with the cattle, and then we'll get the forage wagon. And I'll do a few rounds of the field with the forage wagon rather than getting the windrower, the windrower slash tedder going. I think we'll just go straight for the forage wagon, and we'll see what we can gather up, because we're not going to be able to gather that many rows with this one, because he is a fairly wide cut. So we might actually just get away with leaving it as it is. And then I'm hoping that we can put a little bit of silage in there. Now we've got the bale collector there. That is our milk point, so we can come up here and we can collect the milk if we don't want it to automatically sell at midnight. Just back this one in here. He's quite a wide mower. I don't know if he's actually going to fit in there. Not even close, is he? Will he fit in the one in the... No, the one in the end's got the grass piles. That's the problem. This is such a great map, but everything's so tiny! So small! Right, we're just going to have to park this one in the middle, back here. I come round this side a bit. We'll reverse him round here. And we're going to have to... Because what a lot of farmers used to do, and farmers still do it now, is they don't have the shed space to store things, so they store them outside and put great big tarpaulins over them. So you put a tarpaulin over a machine, and it does a grand job. And I live quite close to the coast, and the farms that actually work right on the coast... hang on a minute. Right, that's everything there. Oh, I really, really apologise for that, ladies and gentlemen. I forgot to put back the manual attachments mod. I was recording some time-lapse footage, and as you know, I don't use the manual attachments mod when I'm doing the time-lapse footage. The reason being, it's just... Because of the time scale, it's just too blurry. It doesn't go well with the actual time lapse. So I took it out and I forgot to put it back in. What was I saying? Yes, I live quite close to the coast. I'll come back. I'll finish telling you that. I'm going to go and get the forage wagon because we're going to run out of time. And I would like to at least give a bit of grass to the cows. There we go. So I have the forage wagon and we're just coming in here. We're going to pick it straight up as it lays. Or at least we're going to start doing that. I may decide in the end to go and get the What's the word I'm looking for? Just put that down. The rake. And rake some of this up after all. We'll see. So yes, as I live quite near to the coast, one of the things that farmers very often will do when they're storing stuff, the farms that live right on the coast, so they've actually got salt in the air, as you can imagine, that is going to accelerate rust of machinery exponentially. You don't find much old machinery lying in a hedge when you're on a coastal farm, because the salt spray just absolutely destroys it. So what they have is an air gun, with a spray can on an air gun, and you fill it up with oil, and before they set something down for storage for any length of time, more than, 3 hours, they spray it with oil. They spray the entire machine with oil, completely coat it, and that does really well. That is a really good protective coating, because the oil slightly hardens after a little while, and then it just stays there as oil, and it doesn't change. You don't have any issues with it, and that can really prolong the life of the machinery. So we could always just imagine that that is what we're doing here, because I think this is how I started on this long rambling tale. I think was we were talking about storing that mower. So we could just imagine that we have sprayed the mower down with oil, because we are a coastal farm here. We're surrounded by ocean on at least two sides. And after we've sprayed it with oil, we put a tarpaulin over it to protect it from the worst of the elements. So that is what we have done with that mower. And anything that we don't put in a shed, we'll have tarps put over it. Anything that is in a shed for any length of time, we'll have to spray that with oil as well. Unfortunately, I've not heard of any mod that would actually do that. So we'll just have to imagine that we've done it. But I think overall, we're not going to have any issues with that. Now then, this is actually working fairly well. It doesn't, you haven't got a huge swath here. But it is working reasonably well, and I think that the tedder, if we were to go around and use that one, it's only really going to move one row over, I think. We might possibly get a row and a half. Not really sure it's even worth us going round with it. We'll have to see. I'll do a few rounds, and then I'll sort of see how I'm getting on with it and what I feel like, because I'm not going to do all of this on screen. I'm going to do some of it this week, and we'll do a little bit more next week, because we're going to be doing some silage. Before I get started next week, that Kirovets will have finished the field that he's in, and I will get him started on the field that the sugar beet was in. I'll get one of the small tractors going on some cultivation. That will be quite simple to get going with that. But I'll also try and get the international going on some more cultivation as well. He can do... we'll hire another cultivator. I think that the actual, the one that we start with in the game, the bog standard one, that is like a very generic looking cultivator, and it certainly it would fit something from 30 odd years ago. When is the 80s? 36 years ago now, isn't it? Crumbs, that's a long time ago. I was born in 1981, so yeah. All of this stuff is slightly older than me, which is quite a worrying thought, really. Crumbs. Okay, let's whiz this one up round. And that was the other thing that we were talking... Whoa! Yeah, that's the one thing about this tractor. He's got a much better turning circle, but he is a little tiny bit slidey when you go around a corner too fast. Does encourage me to actually drive the tractor sensibly. I was trying to hurry because I want to get up here to the cows and feed them and everything, but yeah. He does slide ever so slightly on the corners, and that's the only real complaint, other than the fact that you can't see anything from in the cab. That's kind of a serious issue, but it's something that we can live with, I think. Now, we put this in here, like that. Tip that one out. And we've got the cattle yard. I just realised, where is the manure and where do we put the bedding and stuff like that? So we're going to have a look at. Let's just leave him there tipping. And come down here, because this is the cattle sheds here, and I've parked the mower there. Do we put the straw in this side? You can come through here, and... Ah, yeah, the cattle can come round the back there, so they can get into the shed there, and they can get into this shed here. And then what have we got? This is just like an empty barn almost. So I'm assuming that we put... I'm going to assume that we put straw in here. It looks like there's some remnants of straw just there. So I would assume that we put the straw there. Ooh, That's my timer. That's to say that we have run out of time. I'll do another couple loads between now and next episode. Do a bit with the ploughing, get started on a few other little bits and pieces. But where's the manure from here? I guess that we got to scrape out up through the channel here, a bit like the beef and pigs mod. That's what I'm going to assume on that one. I'm making a lot of assumptions with this. And that might actually be our house. It would certainly be better than the tumble-down pile of bricks that are back at the main yard. I would quite like that being our house, actually. But where is the slurry? There's got to be slurry somewhere. Liquid manure. It says that we've got 10,000. Where is it? I will locate that as well. But for now, let's drive off out to the field. Remember, our question for this week is this Ford tractor that I'm driving right now, right this very second, do you want me to buy it, or do you want me to buy that International that we've been using to do a bit of ploughing? I think you can probably tell from the comments which one I prefer to drive around myself, but I don't want to unduly influence you. I will just say that if you'd prefer me to have the International, I will drive it and I won't complain too much. How's that for just putting in my little tuppence worth? So I do quite like this Ford, and I have spent quite a bit of time driving an old Ford like this. Some good memory, it was a lot of work, but the only International I've driven was actually a much smaller two-wheel drive one, and when I think about my experience driving that tractor, it was just painfully hot, long summer days that weren't fun at all. It's balmy summer days when, you know, the sun is shining and you're on a beach is all well and good, but when you're stuck in a tractor with glass all the way round and no air conditioning in the middle of a huge field of straw, it's a different matter entirely. Suddenly the sun doesn't seem so friendly. So I will continue on with this. If you've enjoyed this episode, please head down below and give us a like, and if you really enjoyed it, then please tell your friends all about me, get them to come and watch as well. That would simply be awesome. Next week, I'll get a bit more of this done, but we're going to do some more grass next week. We'll just sort of finish collecting this up. We've got cultivating to do, we've got seed drilling to do, and the canola is nearly ready to combine, so we do have that to look at as well. Some of this is going to have to go for silage for the cows, and then we're going to have to start seriously thinking about getting mixed feed for the cows. So we're going to have to look at what our options are as far as mixed feed are concerned, because I would like to give the cows the proper mixed rations, which means we're going to have to make some hay, and I'm actually really looking forward to that. I quite like making hay. So I think that's everything. Yeah, I'll stop talking now. I'm going way over time. Thank you very much for watching. This is Frithgar. Goodbye and see you later.